Our son is now 6 months old, and his due date was on March 8th, and the whole week before March 8th, I was trying to induce labor, doing all the things, and I really wanted him to come that week, like a week early, but he didn't. I was shooting for that weekend because the 8th was on a Wednesday, and I really wanted him to come on the weekend. I don't know why, but I think part of it was because our oldest two kids are from a previous marriage of mine, and they would be gone, they would be home that weekend, and then the following weekend they'd be gone, so I was scared that if I had the baby the weekend that they'd gone, it would make me really sad because I wanted them there and be a part of everything. So I was trying, curb walking, walking, pineapple, and dates and teas and everything, and I know not all of those are to like induce labor per se. It's supposed to just like get your body ready for when that time comes, but I was hoping something was gonna like strike that and get things going. Sorry if you can hear our little guy in the background. He's downstairs with his dad and he's getting ready for a nap. But anywho, so I was doing everything I could. TMI, but if you're listening to a birth story, then I think these are things you want to hear. It was a little bit of a rough sleep, but like nothing out of the ordinary. And when I woke up at 3, I was like, I think I'm having some contractions, but I wasn't 100% sure. I wasn't sure if I was just having Braxton Hicks or if it was just like uncomfortable and it would just like go away soon. So I tried to sleep through it, and then it was happening like every 30 minutes, 15 minutes, like it wasn't very consistent. Until I got, actually, maybe it wasn't even that, because I finally got up at 4, so I had to been like, maybe like every 10 minutes. And I started walking around, so 3 o'clock, I start walking around, trying to just make it go away, and then maybe by like 3:30, I think it was, I got back into bed, and I tried to just sleep, go back to bed, sleep through it, and I couldn't, so then I was back up, and then I was back down, and then I was back up, so maybe it was like 10 minutes, every 10 minutes, because I really tried to just sleep through it, and then sleeping's not going to make these go away. I think I'm truly having contractions, and they did start to speed up, So I think at that time we were like 7 minutes apart. It was going quickly. And that's when my husband's alarms like start at 3:30. He's the kind of guy that like taps his alarms, tap, 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 taps the alarms to snooze. And so his first alarms go off at 3:30, and then 4 o'clock. nothing crazy. Like, I didn't really want to talk through them. And I was holding my husband's hand, like, driving and, like, squeezing it, you know, but we were doing okay. And we get to the hospital. So it's probably like 5:40 or so. That probably sounds right. And we get to the emergency room, walk in, and it's kind of a ghost town. Not a whole lot of people in there. And I just tell the people, I'm like, I think I'm in labor. And I didn't want to sit. I wanted to walk. And I asked the guy, I was like, how far is labor and delivery from here? And he's like, oh, don't worry about it. You'll sit in a wheelchair. And I was like, okay, well, I didn't want to, but come to find out, they were so scared that I was going to have a baby right there on their floor, which is super weird, because I thought I was holding it together quite well, but maybe they don't, I don't, I feel like you would hear that all the time in an emergency room, like, I think I'm in labor, I don't know, maybe not, but, so, the guy wheels me back there, my husband's got our bags, we're walking, and we get to labor and delivery, and I get out of the chair, and they're like, okay, like, let's take you into triage and check and see how far you're dilated and all that. So I said, can I walk there? And they're like, sure. I think I made a joke about, like, walking the baby out or whatever, but that was honestly what was going through my mind. Like, I don't want to sit. I want to be up and try to, like, push this baby out as far as I can, because labor's not super fun. So I go ahead and get into the room, and they check me, and I was at 5 centimeters, so they're like, okay, you get to stay. They ask you, like, all these questions to do with, like, health related questions and pain level and all that. So we get through all that, we leave that room, go into labor and delivery room, and that probably takes probably half an hour or so. At this time, maybe it's like 6:15, 6:20 or so, and I'm doing okay. The contractions are there, but I'm, at this point, I was still okay. I could still, I was still talking. And the gals in there, they were so great. They were so sweet. I love labor and delivery nurses. They were the best. So they are putting an IV in, and that was not super fun because my contractions were rearing up a little bit, and having to sit still was kind of hard. But we were still kind of joking, and every time the contractions would come at that point, like, I was still standing. I didn't want to lay in that bed. I held off for as long as I could before they made me get into that bed. Because with the other two kids, I just remember, like, it's a pain that you just can't get away from. It's like you're getting hit by a truck over and over, and you just can't run from it. So I just knew that if I laid down, then I'd be just squirming the whole time, and I'd rather try to, like, walk away from the pain. I don't know if that makes sense, but so I was standing, and I'm leaning on my husband, like, on his shoulders, because he was sitting on the side of the bed, so I'm kind of hunched over. I really wanted this experience to be us together, and I saw a TikTok that was like, you can, like, change your energy. So that was my mindset, that I wanted to have a very together labor and have him included in it all. And I think that was, it was a really nice experience with him. I just can't, he was so great, and he was really calm. We're doing that, and then I don't know why must have just been pacing. Or maybe she took me into the bathroom. Maybe that was it. Maybe she took me into the... I think the lady took me into the bathroom and... Sorry if you can hear the baby. Going down for a nap. So I think she takes... I think she took me into the bathroom, maybe. I don't really remember, but I was on the other side of the bed at this point, and... was still super calm inside this room. He woke himself back up. Everything was so calm in the room at this time, and then I said that, and it was like, okay, well, maybe you need to get into the bed now. And I was like, I don't really feel like lying down at this moment. And she's like, nope, I think if you feel like you need to push, then you need to get into the bed. And so I feel like I need to push, and I honestly just started pushing, standing up, and my husband's like rubbing my back because I hadn't laid down yet. And so she calls in all the other like nurses, and then we are swarmed. Everybody's in there, all hands on deck, and we're just ready. My midwife was not on, she was not scheduled to work that day. So we had the just on-call midwife. Sorry, I'm not picking my nose up, dry skin. So they had just called the on-call midwife to get there because she lived like 15 minutes away. But it was just so fast that the were closed, and I they were not very nice. The ladies in labor and delivery were so amazing that I just wanted to like take all them and bring them with me. So that all happened. He was born at 6:40. So by the time we left our house, it was close to just an hour of wrapping your brain around. 6:40 in the morning, he's here, and we go do postpartum, we get set up, and I was ready to go home. I did not like the stay, and we got to go home the next day at noon, but it's just a long day inside the hospital, not my favorite. So anyway, so we stay. Thank you.